Hello guys, my name is John Mukanya. I'm a CEO and founder at JDDev. For today's video, we're going to start with some lessons on C# in 2022. Let's first define a .NET. It is a software development framework developed by Microsoft for running and building Windows applications. It consists of developer tools, programming languages, and libraries to build desktop, API, and web applications. So once you install Visual Studio on Windows, then it will come to a section whereby you need to select it, some templates and the programming language that you want to install. So make sure that you select .NET framework, or you can also install, but I think for this video, we are not going to focus on .NET Core. So just install .NET Framework, a console application template, and also Windows Form template, including C#. So you will see it will be Windows Form for DB. Don't install that, just install the one for C#. So make sure that you are selecting the one for C#. But for .NET framework, it's actually wrapping everything. Okay, so you don't have to worry about that. Just install .NET framework. The only thing that you need to pay attention is actually the template. When you're installing those templates, you need to make sure that it's actually for C# or for C++. But we're only going to focus on C# on this tutorial. One of the .NET components is CLR, which stands for Common Language Runtime. It allows also to handle any exception that might occur on our system, right? And also, it's a garbage collection for removing any unwanted resources. And then we have class, library, and languages. So let's talk about .NET Core Framework. It's a new version of .NET Framework, and then it's also an open source. It allows us to, once we create our application, it can be used on different operating system. So it doesn't matter if you build an application on Windows, you must just have to use it on Windows. You can also use it on Mac OS or Linux. So that's why I mentioned in here that is a cross-platform framework. And then by the time you want to deploy it on the server, you can use the service like IIS or Apache. And then there's many more services that you can use. While on .NET framework, we only have to use WIS. That was the only service that we have to use, which was provided by Microsoft. So let's talk about C#. So C# is one of the object-oriented programming that has been also created by Microsoft, and then it's run on top of .NET framework, and it actually derived from C language. So here are the different types of application that we can build using C#: desktop, web, web service, game, VR, which stands for virtual reality, and game database application, and many more. So VR, so it's those kind of game that you need to wear a headset, and then it also has when you're playing a game, there's an avatar that will be representing you on the game. So, and then it will make you feel that you're on the game, not just playing a game, but you will be feeling that you're actually on the game. Right. So once you install Visual Studio, then you can start creating your first application. And then for Linux user, so I believe I'm going to use this thing to place it on the comment, and then you can just use it to follow up with the step how you can install .NET framework on your system. So let's start by creating our first application. So I believe, let's see. First of all, I have to create a folder that will have the same name as my application. So it will be Hello World. Okay, so let me just close this one. And then open it. I have to open it on the terminal. Then from here, we can just say .NET. We should be a new console application. So a console application is just where you need to provide your code, and then once you run your program, there will be a black screen that will use. It's going to be used to display your output. And then if you want to create a graphic user interface, then you have to make use of a window form or WPF. So those two are used to build a desktop application. So let me open it on my test editor. Okay, so here's the main file. So once we run our program, this file will be executed. So if you can see, so let's talk about the syntax of C#. So you see that we type using system. That means that we want to use all the classes of that's coming from system. Namespace hello underscore world. That means that it's actually pointing to the folder that I just created. And then this is the name of the class, and then this is the method. So it's static because it actually standalone is not actually linked to an object of the class. And then we specify void, which is going to be it's written nothing. And then main to specify that this is going to be the main entry. So once this once it's called, it's accessed this particular file, then it will look for the main method somewhere there. And then this is going to be the argument. So instead of this method, so we already have, so it's been generated by C# or by the command that I just ran. That's why you see that we have a console.writeLine, and then we are writing this test on the console. Okay, so that's why we say that it's a console application. So let me just run our program. To run it, we just have to say .NET and then run. You see if we can see the output, the level or the string value that we have of hello world. Here we go. So we're just going to change it to well done. Okay. So meaning good. So our first step is to create a variable. So I will show you and explain all those keywords. So I'm just going to grab some files. Okay, so when we're talking about syntax, so syntax is actually the way that we're using a programming language. So you can see Python has its own syntax. Are you going to use it? So C# also has the way that you're going to use its code. So like in English, the way you're using grammar in English, then that is actually, it actually referred as a syntax in Korean. So syntax is the same thing as grammar. Okay. So I think according to my notes, I just have to show you how you can comment. So this is going to be a single comment. And then this is going to be a block of comment or multiple line comment. Multi-line comments. Oh, block of comments. Okay, that is done. Create variables using C# in 2022. So before we can create a variable, we need to talk about the data type. So like in Python, we don't have to mention the data type when we're creating a variable, but in C#, it's a must. So we have a string integer, so it's going to be short for int, character, double, float. For other, we're going to cover that later on. We have bool for boolean. So I'm going to start by creating a string variable. We have string first name equals to Joe, and then string last name equals to Peter. Int age equals to 13. Double, so it will be, I'm going to use floats. So, but if you're expecting a huge range of numbers for decimal number, you have to stick with double. So if it's just a small range of number, then you can stick with float. So since it will be salary, and I must use double. Okay, and then you can see that every time that we end a particular line, we need to include a semicolon. So this is a correct syntax in C#. So you need to pay attention when you're coding in C#. And then what next? That's it for now. Let's display the value. Console.WriteLine. Then you need to display. So you can put a dollar sign before your string value, your double quotation, and then we specify name colon use carry bracket, then we specify first name your line seven. surname and be last name. So let's run our program. That's it for now. See you on our next video. Please subscribe, share, and like the video. Bye.